So hang tight. Everybody who called in now, just hang tight. And, yeah, we'll work with what we got. And hopefully some more of these students will call in to share their views with us. So, yeah, what the point that I wanted to highlight, this class has mostly white students in it. And I think the people that are on the line now can verify that. Far and away, way more white students than non-white students. And we have two non-white students on the line and one white student. That right there is exactly why the description reads the way it does. We have a class of suspected racists. If these white people were really interested in replacing white supremacy with justice, I would have more white people here. I would not just have Spencer hanging out on the line. Justice, are you with us?
Yes, I am.
Outstanding. Okie dokie. This is the class from the University of Washington. They're focusing on racism, white supremacy, and Tupac Shakur. If you have some questions you would like to ask, please go right ahead.
How do you practice white supremacy every day? Hello?
Is that question towards anyone in specific?
Do you think you can each answer? Please?
I mean, as a white person,
Is there only one white person?
I believe so. I think I'm the only one.
Okay, so that's you, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How do you practice white supremacy every day?
Well, I personally don't consider myself a white supremacist. I took the class in order to learn more, you know, to promote justice and to help, you know, learn more about the topic so I can, you know, help educate others about it. I personally don't consider myself to practice white supremacy. I don't do anything specifically to subject people to, you know, unequal, you know, standings within society. I don't think I practice white supremacy.
I think there's some distortion in that.
What's that?
Whoever's in the car, if you could mute your phone while you are, I guess, getting settled, if you're going to a destination or what have you, because we're picking up the distortion in the broadcast. Thank you so much. Okay. I'm sorry for interrupting, Justice. If you want to continue, please.
Okay. That'll be all for now.
Did you want everyone to respond to your question, or did you just want Spencer? Spencer is a white person, correct?
Correct.
Okay. Yeah, did you want
but he said that he's not a racist, so I was going to ask him a few questions about white supremacy. But, but that's all for now.
Okay. Do you suspect that Spencer could be a racist white supremacist?
Yes.
Okay. Why do you suspect that?
He's white.
How do you feel about that, Spencer?
It's kind of, just to clarify, she said that she said yes. Is that correct? She does suspect that?
Yes.
Okay. I understand just from taking this course, actually, you know, the position that non-whites, you know, are, you know, have to take against this. For me, it's kind of upsetting just because for me personally, I like to give people an opportunity to get to know me, and I like to get to know them, and I like to establish that, you know, respect and trust, I guess. So it's kind of upsetting just because I don't like to be suspected of being a white supremacist. I like people to get to know me and my character. I understand where you're coming from, you know, being suspicious of that.
All
Very interesting. Do you think there's anything incorrect about non-white people, victims of racism, white supremacy, being suspicious of you as a white person?
It's not that I think there's anything incorrect. I think that, unfortunately, we've come to a place in time where, you know, non-whites have to feel that way. I guess I hope that, you know, we can eventually get to a point where people can, you know, give the opportunity to learn about, you know, the content of someone's character, opposed to, not to quote, I'm okay, but...
Sorry. Oh, man. Man, oh, man. I played Mr. Robertson to introduce the program because I'm very comfortable, as comfortable as a slave can be on the plantation. I'm about that comfortable now. I feel to have white people and white people, Spencer, white people have scoffed repeatedly in your class about being referenced as suspected racist. Many of them read the description for this program and contacted more powerful people at the University of Washington and griped and complained. Oh my gosh. Oh, suspected white supremacist, suspected racist. Oh my God, I cannot believe this. We're not in for open dialogue. And what you just said, there is absolutely nothing incorrect about a non-white person being suspicious of a white person as long as we are in a system of white supremacy. There's nothing incorrect about it, and that is the logical stance to take for non-white people, victims of racism. I want everybody to, and Spencer, can you verify this, that a lot of white people in your class, suspected white supremacists, have complained consistently about being referenced, well, not even themselves, it's not even personal, but they have complained about non-white people saying they should be suspicious of white people in a system of white supremacy. Is that accurate from what you have observed?
I think people, you know, more so, I don't know, I guess when things are thrown out like white supremacy, I think the white students feel almost like they're being persecuted for being white supremacists.
Okay. Well, wait a minute, Spencer. And I'm going to bring somebody else on because we might have another classmate here. 360, are you one of the students that's supposed to be participating in this class?
Yeah.
Okay, are you a white person?
No, I'm not white. I'm black.
Keep this in mind, ladies and gentlemen, the folks that are listening in. We now have three non-white students, and we still just got Spencer with a suspected racist Spencer. The rest of the gang, this is why the description reads the way it does. There are at least, I think, at least 15 white students in this class. Does that number sound in the ballpark, Spencer?
Yeah, about that.
Okay. Now I want to get back to the question that I asked Spencer here, and I want to get the non-white people's commentary on this in a hot second, but you all know the cows, we like to focus attention on white people. I asked you, have white people consistently complained about the suggestion that non-white people be suspicious of white people in a system of white supremacy? You just said that is a logical stance to take. There's nothing incorrect about it, but the white people have complained about this consistently. That's the specific question that I asked. So can I get a yes or no to that, and then you can share whatever thoughts. Have the white people complained about that suggestion consistently in the course?
From what I understand, yes.
Okay. See, now whatever thoughts you have around that, please share with us, Spencer.
I think the reason why people are complaining about it, and you know, I don't know who's complaining, I don't know who's sending the email specifically, but I think the reason why is because, you know, as white people, we feel, you know, because we're being suspected of being white supremacists, we feel like we're being, you know, judged and, you know, not persecuted, but, you know, we're kind of like immediately have a negative connotation because, you know, people assume that we're white supremacists.
Well, wait a minute now, Spencer. See, that's what I said. You got to be real. Excuse me?
I used the wrong word. I said assume.
Thank you, Spencer. Got to be on your toes about words with these white people, which is why you're under suspicion, Spencer, because it has been my observation white people tend to brag about their precision with words. I observe this every day. So it just strikes me as very suspicious when white people suddenly become so careless, and it doesn't say assume these white people are racist. It says suspect that they could be. It doesn't say assume anywhere in the description for this program. It says suspect racist. So that's why you're still under suspicion, Spencer. Justice, excellent job. I suspect Spencer is most likely a racist white supremacist myself. But I could be wrong. And he is here. None of the other white people have been thus far. Whoever's in the car, you're making noise again.
I'm leaving the car. I'm getting on a train right now, so I actually have to go soon. But
He has to go soon. That's why you're a suspect, Spencer. That's why.
I understand that, but I think that there's also, I mean, to be completely honest with you, I'm attending a funeral and I have to get there. And I think that it's, I don't think it's right to immediately suspect that someone being a white supremacist. I mean, I'm not going to hang up the phone with a white supremacist.
Spencer, you just said there is nothing incorrect about a non-white person, victim of white supremacy, suspecting that a white person could be a racist. Did you forget that you just said that on this broadcast?
No, I understand.
Okay,
that, I mean.
Well, wait a minute, Spencer. That's the problem that we have. You can't say it's correct. It's logical for you to be suspicious and then come back 10 minutes later with some sort of personal indignation. Oh, I just think it's really bad that you don't even get to know me and that there's some sort of judgment being made about me before you know anything about my life. You can't do that, Spencer, unless you want to confirm my suspicions that, yeah, this guy's trying to confuse us. He's trying to practice racism, white, because that's what it sounds like to me, Spencer.
I'm sorry, it sounds that way.
The non-white people that are on the line, could you share your thoughts with us about what you have observed in the class, and even if you like what you have heard from Spencer?